So today I concluded another special class on baklava and kunafa. Okay, I had eight students today. I have two from Thane, one from Mathura, my old student, Ahmedabad. We have Surat, we also have Noida, and we have Bangalore. Okay, so coming to your kunafa and baklava. So I showed you how the baklava sheets are used, the phyllo pastry sheets, how you defrost it, how you can utilize all your sheets, how you can store it back again in the freezer, and whatever your sheets are, there is no wastage. We can utilize every sheet by having different variations and shapes in your baklava. So coming to your different shapes, we have done four variations of baklava today. One is your rhombus shape. So that's your rhombus shape baklava, which I taught you today in a square and a square tin basically. And I've also done my layers with pistachio and walnut, crushed pistachios and walnut. We did a honey cinnamon syrup made from scratch. When is the right time to pour the syrup, and then you add your dry fruits and your rose buds and rose petals on top for garnishing. Okay, so and that's directly you put it in your box, and this box can be given away as it is. Now coming to your different shapes and variations, we have done one which is your baklava nest, baklava cup. This is in a cupcake style where I have put some dry fruits inside plus on the top. And as soon as your baklava comes out from your oven, directly your hot syrup is poured. Okay, so hot syrup is poured in your hot, your cold syrup is poured in your hot baklava. Make sure your syrup is made before you start baking your baklava. Okay, again, this is your roll form or a puff form. In this also, what we have done is we have given that look wherein you stuff your fillings, your dry fruits in between. Then as soon as it comes out, we've added a syrup and we've garnished it with your pistachios and walnuts. This is your Nutella baklava nest. Again, I showed you how you can make the nest, the design of the nest. You can have various spreads on top. Like today I've done it with Nutella. You can use cream cheese, matcha spread, your pistachio spread. You can even directly put your dry fruits. You can take chocolate. So you can call it as your chocolate baklava by putting a chocolate piece. So you have different variations even in your nest. When it comes to having in a box, we can have various shapes in a box where you have an assorted box of all different shapes. Okay, we've covered the costing and pricing also of your baklava, your storage and your shelf life, how your shelf life of your baklava will be. Coming to your kunafa, today I made your mini kunafas with little different shapes. Okay, so coming to your kunafa, I have done with smaller portions where I've used 1/4 of my quantity in my recipe. This is a cheese pudding where I showed you how a cheese pudding is made, what type of savaiya is to be used. And originally I told you it's katefi that you can use for your kunafas. Now coming to your cheese pudding, I also taught you how to make your syrups. So syrups are your basically your scented syrup that we have used to make, to put on top of your kunafa. For decoration, you have to use your pistachios and your rosebuds. I've given a look of my silver work today, just to give it a little mithai and a traditional look to your kunafa. Okay, now I've told you how the kunafa is stored, what is the shelf life, what is the costing, and how you'll put them in boxes. Like last time when I had a box of four kunafa, I had taken a rectangular box where I had placed my kunafas, four kunafas diagonally, and my syrup which went separately in a container. Okay, so this is how you're supposed to serve your kunafas. They are eaten hot and with a cool syrup again on the top. And when you cut it, you should have that cheesy layer, coming out from your kunafa kunafa layer. Okay. Any questions?
Kashish, can you please repeat that costing wala part?
For kunafa or for baklava?